On February 26th, an Icelandair 767 made a very special visit to the Troll Research Station in Antarctica. It was brought there to pick up researchers who were headed home after the southern summer season, flying from Reykjavik to Cape Town and then another 5 hours or so down to the Troll airfield. On the return, it stopped off at Cape Town again and then Oslo to drop everyone off before heading back to home base. We spoke with Sven Lidstrom, the operations manager at Troll Station, and he gave us some details about what it takes to receive a 767 in Antarctica, how they built the blue ice runway, and more. We'll link the special podcast episode with Sven and the blog post with all kinds of details below. The folks down at the Norwegian Polar Institute were kind enough to share some videos with us, which we've cut together here. This runway was built in 2005 in order to give researchers easier access to the station. Before that, they either had to take a boat from Cape Town and trek 250 kilometers to the station, or fly to another research base and connect on a smaller aircraft to Troll. This runway means they can leave Norway and be here no more than 24 hours later. The 3,000-meter runway is built on a glacier, elevation about 1,250 meters above sea level. In the initial construction, workers took about 2 years to prepare the ice using a laser cutter. Throughout the season, it requires constant maintenance. Not only that, but because it's on a glacier, the runway moves a little every year. Lately, with warmer temperatures, they struggle to keep it cold enough during the summer. When it's above freezing, aircraft can't land here. Starting about 5 days before an arriving flight, they consult with weather forecasters at a German research station. They fine-tune the arrival time accordingly. Weather is critical. Lidstrom says a recent storm there clocked winds of 98 meters per second. That's about 220 miles per hour. There's no radar here, but they have an ADS-B receiver connected to Flight Radar 24. Satellite phones, VHF and HF radios are used for comms. For this flight, the 767 tankered in enough fuel so that it didn't need to fill up at Troll. Lidstrom says fuel is especially expensive in Antarctica, which is no surprise, so planes with the range to arrive and go back have an advantage. Not to mention that gives them the option to return to Cape Town in the event of bad weather, closing in unexpectedly. Troll Station does have a fueling container though, and they can do pressure fueling like any other airport. So who else wishes they'd been on this flight? And what's the most remote airfield you've ever flown to? Let us know down in the comments. For Flight Radar 24, this is Gabriel Lee.